Morning all. Today I want to tell you something about the Irish Terrier, which is a bigger type of terrier found in Ireland. Its color is red, and next to those red colorations also a little bit allusions to, for example, almost wheaten, but there's always a red color found in them. Also some go to a reddish chocolate color. But color is not the most important. It's a bigger terrier. It's like a fox terrier, but then the wire head, but then bigger. And also a racier frame. This means it's for a terrier quite fast. And it's nowadays not often used as a working dog, a working terrier. It's sometimes crossed into, for example, greyhounds to make a sturdier dog, also with a good coat. And it's also sometimes crossed into a whippet. You could do the same, but then in a smaller frame. Irish Terrier has a coat that is comparable to the hypoallergenic breeds, so all the doodles out there and also the poodles, so which makes it a breed you can look into to see if it suits your need and also if the coat is what you really like. Hypoallergenic dogs are a little bit overrated, because it's not only about the hairs, especially the body fluids, for example, saliva or excrements that give the allergenic components. So if a dog is mouthy and will bite you, it will probably have more influence than some hairs. Also, the dander just falls off anyway, and that contains a lot more allergenic content than the hairs do. So just a small reminder for those people that are really dog allergic, it can be better than a dog that sheds a lot, for sure. And also one must remember there's a psychological interaction between the mind and what one conceives, and the body, how it will react. So just some pointers. Also in the terrier group, there are some breeds that do not shed or have hairs that are hard to inhale. For example, the Irish Terrier, as I mentioned. The Irish Terrier also has a nickname, the Daredevil, because like all other terriers, they have the tenacity and can-do attitude, which I really like. I love that in terriers. They don't complain, they just do. And they go for it wholeheartedly. This is my little black terrier. It's a Pattedale Terrier, 11 months old now. Also known as Black Fell, Smooth Fell. His name is BSL's Estacado. He's a lot smaller than the Irish Terrier is. It's more of a go-to-ground type of terrier. I think at least as courageous. So it's not all about size. The Irish Terrier, however, will be a faster dog in the field, because it has additional length of paws and also a lighter frame, because a Pattedale or Fell Terrier often brings maximum substance to put in a relatively small hole, and that's a different attitude to bringing a dog that has a more racy setup. I think the crosses between Irish Terriers, Whippets, and our Greyhounds to make a lurcher could be very successful. You still have Terrier attitude if you get a good Irish Terrier in there. You bring better coat, you get a Terrier with quite a racy frame. So it could all add up to good things. But perhaps there are better choices. For example, working a Bedlington, or a smaller degree of working working Petitil, for example. Or for example, also the Yacht Terrier. It's also a little bit more a racy frame as compared to the Petitil, because it's not only for work on the ground but also to cover big distances above ground when they're hunting hawks. This is a real hunting terrier. A little bit more quarrelsome and also a little bit more to the smaller size, but for a Whippet cross, when you're looking for a smaller terrier lurcher, this could be perfect. And if you use workers, you have the benefit of those working ancestry, and a purpose-bred dog is almost always better than a dog combined of show stock or just companion stock. Okay, have a good day, y'all.